If you have any specifically two international classic films, or two classic Indian films for that matter, that have had the deepest influence on your life while growing up, maybe even got you started in terms of your love for films.
So there's two parts of it, right? One is just like, which are the movies that you remember from your childhood, which are the ones that just got you into the movies, and then there's the films that influenced you as a filmmaker. I think there's a, one has to separate both those things. It's not the same. It's not like, yeah, ye picture dekh ke jab main 6 saal ka tha toh main usme director ban jaunga. Aisa to kabhi hota nahi hai. You don't realize that until you're like 18 or something. So when I was a kid, I grew up, I was born in the mid 70s, grew up watching Amitabh Bachchan, was the biggest fan, as I think every person my age at that time was. I think there was only one god and he was Mr. Bachchan. And so grown up, of course, watching Sholay multiple times, and Amar Akbar Anthony was my favorite film, you know, back in the day, which, you know, used to be the family watch that one would kind of do. And then as, you know, he whatever would come after that, yeah, of Mr. Bachchan, you know, Mard or Coolie or any of these things. And I think with the rest of the country, everybody was, when he got hit in Coolie and he was in hospital, the sabko pata tha. Even as a, you know, 7-year-old, you knew that he was in hospital, and so it was a big deal, yeah. So it was like, but that was the getting into the movies, getting into what, the adoration of a star. You know, there was a big difference in that. I think once there was a choice to become a filmmaker, or what, you know, when you want to be, what drives you, I had a big, unlike a lot of my contemporaries and people maybe slightly younger than me, that I had a massive rejection of Indian cinema in the 90s. I just didn't, because of what was happening in Hollywood cinema in the 90s.
When did you start discovering Hollywood films? As a kid only you were watching them?
As a kid, I think by the late 80s, we were already watching them already. Yeah. Back to the Future, dekh liya tha, Die Hard, dekh liya tha. When Terminator 2 came out, it was like the biggest thing ever. Like that film is still, I mean, there's a poster somewhere.
Yeah, yeah.
It's just still like...
Back to the Future ka to hai yahi pe.
Wo to hai. This is like favorite movie. Yeah. Die Hard ka bhi kahin hai. Yeah. Idhar hai kahin. So that was because of what was happening there. And then that... The big James Cameron movies, or the, you know, the action set pieces. Like, I loved those films. And then you had in the 90s, which was the whether it's Reservoir Dogs or Pulp Fiction, or Danny Boyle doing Trainspotting, or Nolan coming in with Memento, or, you know, so there suddenly you felt that, and David Fincher, you know, doing Seven and stuff. You're like, wow, this is just a whole other kind of cinema. That I know that me and Anurag and a lot of us are very, very influenced by that. So those are the broad kind of things. Specifically when it comes to movies, I think with Indian movies, very influenced by Pyasa. I still remember the first time I saw Pyasa was at the original Mami. I think it was 97 or 98 or something. There was a Tata Theatre in the NCPA. Had a double, evening screenings were, there was a, it was a Doctor Strangelove followed by Pyasa.
Okay.
It was the most surreal double bill.
Yeah.
But... so we went to see Dr. Strangelove, and a lot of us are why in the packed theater for seeing Dr. Strangelove. Kubrick's picture. But if anybody who's seen Dr. Strangelove knows that it's not a film you get in the first time you watch it. The humor is very like, but if you've seen it before, it's fantastic. So me and some other guy sitting next to me had seen it before. Hum toh pagal ho rahe the picture. We were like laughing our asses off and all that. And then that film finished, and then Pyasa started, and Pyasa ke time pe, I think 80% of the audience left.
Are you serious?
Yeah, yeah. And it was just...
Oh, wow.
It was very surprising and very sad. And even then, when the 20% left, when Gaana shuru hota hai, toh ek wo, you know, like very arty South Bombay type reactions would come, and very disheartening. But also, when you're watching Pyasa on a screen, it's quite an experience. And I think that film and just the artistry that Gurudat, I think, brought to the table, I think for me, watching that was a huge revelation in terms of, you know, the storytelling capabilities of what one can do, you know, of pushing the boundaries, of having comical moments in a tragic film about a poet, and then there's also mystery and mistaken identity, and kitna sara masala tha yaar us picture mein, you know, even though on the surface it feels, when you talk people like Pyasa, they feel like, oh, tragedy, and it's not, it's just like there's so much more to it than just than that, and I thought that was just phenomenal. Then after that was a discovery of Ray, which has been another massive kind of revelation for me in terms of the just the breadth of stories that he's been able to tell, whether it's Charulata, whether it's Jol Shakhor, whether it's any of the Apu trilogy, or Mahanagar or Nayak or Kapurush, Mahapurush. I mean, the guy, he's a magician. Like every film of his is just completely, you know, magical and unique. And again, pushing the boundaries of storytelling, pushing the boundaries of shot taking. Like, and you look at it back in the day, like, you can't believe that these guys are sort of like doing that kind of stuff. So there's that. And then, so within, I mean, from Ray's films, again, I can't really choose one. But the other films, if I have to choose like the two Indian films that have influenced me the most, I would say one is Pyaasa and I say the second is Black Friday.
Okay.
You know, because again, just Anurag at that time making this really, really layered, incredible film about the blasts and about the way it happened, where there's a sense of, there's a detachment and yet there's a sense of empathy for everybody in that film, not just
with much more nuance than what anyone else was doing at that time.
100%, much more nuance and just, and stylish and fun and great writing and great characters and, you know, like just great setups. And again, you're just like, when someone pushes the boundary like that, and and Black Friday, I mean, I had worked with Anurag on Paan, so I was a friend, you know, I was going on set, and then on Black Friday, he wanted me to cut the trailers of it, and I did the original trailer and all the things. And also, I've seen that film multiple times. So there's a bit of a study that's kind of happened on that. And I'm always, every time I watch it, I'm always just amazed, you know, just completely in awe of what, you know, what Anurag was doing in that film, and the way that, you know, how a director, a writer, everything kind of comes together to sort of. And I guess from Hollywood, it's kind of tough to say. This is Back to the Future's. Always, like, if I have to say, if I choose one film as my favorite film, it's probably Back to the Future. But there's also, right up there is Seven Samurai. And everything that Kurosawa does, I think, is just phenomenal.
Of course, 400 Blows, I know that it was a big influence for you.
400 Blows is a big influence. Hitchcock's work is a massive influence. Notorious is a huge influence. Anything that Hitchcock does, actually. When it comes, especially from writing, how to write characters in situations has been a huge influence. And then in the 90s, like, David Fincher has been my favorite go-to director. I think Fight Club is probably the film I've seen the most number of times. Just at any point in time, go back and watch them. Nolan's work has been massively influential about how to be able to take interesting cerebral subjects and turn them into these blockbusters, which, you know, in the hands of any other filmmaker is just going to end up becoming one of those head scratchers. But Nolan turns them into these event movies that you know, that really engage you, and I think that's it's fascinating. So, so that's long story short. Ek picture nahi hai, bahut sari picture hai, bahut sare filmmakers hai. It's not just about a film; it's about a filmmaker and their. Because once you, the thing is, then I think as a film student, it tends to happen. Once you've seen a film that or a filmmaker you really like, then you there's a tendency to like really get into their entire filmography and saying, yeah, what have I missed? You know, so you go deep dive. Then it's a full deep dive into watching. Which currently, well, afterwards, even the modern day, whether it's Michael Haneke, you know, to a certain point, or Ruben Östlund today, you know, where once you've seen Force Majeure in the square, and then you wonder, like, yeah, kya karta hai aadmi, kaise karta hai, what is the, you know, what's the thing, so.